Hello guys, today I thought I'll make a short video blog on how to buy a step-up transformer and what step-up transformer to buy for running an Indian wheat grinder. I personally have been like searching for this for a long time. I wasn't sure which one to buy and you know which one would work for my ultra wheat grinder that I got from India. So basically this one is a Rockstone Power. It's a step up and step down transformer, and it is like the max capacity is 1000 watts, and it does both step up and step down. So as you can see that the front panel here has the output, you know, it can produce both 110 if the input is 220 or 240, and at the same time it can produce 220 volts output if the input is 110, which is the case here in US, right? So I just thought I'll make a short video blog, so let's just get started with this. So the step-up transformer and the step-down, step-up and down transformer, actually. It actually came in this box here. It got delivered today. So it actually came in pretty good shape. There were no dents or damage or anything of that sort. And inside that there was this two information pamphlets here that 500 watt transformer can only be used for an appliance that uses 300 watts. So I mean not exactly three times, I think around two times. Yeah, so basically if your grinder, I think this one here is using 80 watts is what I saw in the manual of this grinder. So ideally, you know, I should have been better off with 200 watt step up transformer, but anyway, I just went ahead and bought 1000 watt because this particular company only makes transformers that start at 1000 watts. So technically this 1000 watt transformer can power appliances. The total number of appliances that are connected to this transformer cannot exceed 500 watts, right? So that's the rule of thumb. So if your appliance uses 600 watts, then this transformer will probably blow up, you know. I think that's the deal there. Anyway, that's what this says. And then it also says how to switch your voltage. So basically here it says that if you want to convert 110 to 220, which is the case here in US, you need to switch the tab on the back side of it, which I will show in a bit. And similarly, if you want to convert 220 to 110, that is if you are using this transformer in India, and if you want to connect a device that is made in US, then this section applies. But you know, in my case, I'm in US, so converting 110 to 220 is what I actually care about. So it says that you have to switch a plug on the back of it, like a tab. You have to put it in the right slot, which I'll show it in a bit. And then it says that, you know, I think this comment came, you know, all over the place in Amazon reviews. It said that there is this weird smell that keeps coming when you are using it, and this pamphlet says that is completely harmless and it's just coming from the insulation material. And actually I didn't notice the smell yet. Maybe I don't know, if I keep using it maybe I may notice it, but so far I didn't notice the smell yet. And this sheet here tells about, you know, what are all the typical watts of typical appliances. And this is just more for information, but I wouldn't go by this. I would actually look at the actual appliances manual to see how much power it consumes before I buy the transformer. So this is the rear of the transformer, and this is where you need to use that switch to decide what input volt you are giving it to the transformer. So here, since we are in US, the input is 110, so basically you need to put this tab here, this particular tab, in the 110 volt slot. It's just like a plug and play kind of simple tab. So I mean, since we are in US and this is the standard US power socket, which is 110, like I have put that little tab in the 110 volt slot. If you are in India and if you want to step down that voltage to 200 and I mean like from 240 to 110, then you would put that little tab here in 240, or if you are or 220, or if you are in some other place, some other country where the input is 200 volts, then you'll put in the 200 volt slot. Yeah, that's all there is to it. And in the front, you know, these are the outputs. So plug my bit grinder into the 220 volt slot. And then once you have done that, you know, you can just power it on. As you can see that the red LED light is on. Looks like it also comes with a 5 volt USB output. I'm probably not going to use that, but it just comes with that as well. So I've turned it on. So now, you know, the grinder is plugged into it. And if I power it on, it works. Yeah, so it works. So the Indian wet grinder that was bought in India and that is designed for 220 volts 50 hertz frequency actually works with US input, which is 110 volts 60 hertz, and this transformer seems to do the job. Yeah, so that's all I had. So I will put the link to this product in the description box below, and keep you posted in case if you know, if this device gives me a problem going on, I'll update this video later, but for now it seems to work fine. Thank you for watching. Bye.